Hi guys, today we are doing some healthy cake, something which is not other than the chocolatey, yeah, with vegetables and flour. Okay, let me walk you through the ingredients. So first I have grated 3 medium sized carrot, 1 medium sized beetroot, and these are the dry fruits. It has walnuts, almonds, pistachio, cashew. Have dry roasted them. Next here comes the honey, it's quite optional. This is wheat flour, this is jowa, and this is maida. Instead of maida, you can also grind your oats, and it also gives a nice binding. Maida is just for binding. Main ingredients are wheat and jowa. Next here we have powdered sugar, 2 eggs, and this is a vanilla essence. So let us start the process. First beat 2 eggs in a large bowl. So the egg should release the form. See, now you can see the bubbles. So it should be beaten like this. And to this, you're gonna add 1/2 cup of powdered sugar. So I'm adding 3 spoons of powdered sugar, 3 large spoons, and this gives me 1/2 cup of powdered sugar. So I already added 1, 2, the last one. Yeah, this gives me 1/2 cup of powdered sugar. So beat it nicely. So once you feel your egg is coated with the powdered sugar, you're gonna add 2 tablespoons of honey. It's quite optional. If you don't want to add, you can add more powdered sugar, or you can use maple syrup instead. I've added honey here and beating it again. Get a nice stir. Add 1 tablespoon of vanilla essence. Beat it again. If you guys wanted to be the cake to be vegan, you can use baking soda and baking powder together instead of using the eggs. And you also need to require some yogurt to make the cake and to bind the flour. Best option is to use the eggs for the cake. And next comes the baking powder. You're gonna add 1 large tablespoon of baking powder. Next, you're gonna add all your dry ingredients. This is the 1/2 cup of jowa. So if you're using 1 cup of wheat flour, then you need to use 1/2 cup of jowa. And this is 1 cup of wheat flour. I'm going to add the maida at last after binding all these 2. Yeah, now I added 1/2 cup of maida and the other 1/2 I kept aside. I need to see the consistency and then add all the dry ingredient. So mix this mixture very well. So yeah, it's so wet, so I think I need to add the other cup of maida too. Okay, mix it very well, and then you're going to add your grated vegetables, grated raw vegetables. The vegetables to the dry and wet ingredients. Now mix the mixture very well. So don't worry if your mixture is too thicky, because we are going to bind it with milk at last. So milk is your secret ingredient. This is how the texture looks like. I mean the color. It looks like as if you are making a red velvet cake, but not. So on this I'm going to add few dry fruits. I just want them to go inside my cake, not just as the toppings. So I'm adding few to the cake mixture. Actually, this is not a cake mixture. This is just the dough which you prepared. And now you're going to make it into cake batter. So you need milk for it. Do not use warm milk. Keep your milk at the room temperature. I'm going to add milk. I'm using about 1/2 glass of milk, and check before you get the running consistency, because it should not be so running. So let's check. So to be honest, I haven't used even 1/2 cup of milk. I just used like almost 3 tablespoons of milk. So yeah, my mixture is good. My cake mixture is good, and it's also runny. Yeah, you can see. Yeah, now it's good to go, and you're ready to bake. So let's prep our cake tin. So you can use any cake tin. Generally I used to use this for small cakes. So I think my battery is more today, so I am using this round wala cake tin. This is very old. So you need to grease your cake tin first. So I'm going to use neutral light. You can use any butter, oil, ghee or anything which is available. So I'm using neutral light to grease my pan. So if you guys can see, I greased my pan very well. So yeah, it's so greasy. I don't know why people dust their cake tins. I don't like dusting my cake tin because I want this flavor to get inside the cake while it's cooking. I wanted it to be so soft and so yeah, I do not dust my cake tins ever. So yeah, now put the batter in the cake tin. After your battery is transferred into your cake tin, you need to dab your cake tin like this, very hard and very loud, because you should make sure there are no air bubbles formed inside your batter. So dab it like 2 to 3 times. Now I'm gonna add the toppings. Those are the roasted dry fruits on top. I just crushed them a little bit because I don't want the chunks between my cake. So yeah, my cake batter is ready. So for your surprise, I'm not using the oven. I'm not going to put this batter in the oven. I'm gonna use a pressure cooker. I recommend not to use steel. So you can use any hot and thick pan or pressure cooker. And now inside this, I've poured normal salt. Normal salt which you use for cooking. You can use any kind of salt, crystal salt or any salt, and you can, it's also reusable. I mean, after this you can transfer it in your storage container and you can reuse it. I've been using this salt and this cup for almost like 7 to 8 times, and after that you have to use a new salt because it will be becoming so much burnt and smoked. So that flavor should not go into your baking items. So you just use salt for 3 to 4 times maximum. So now I'm gonna put my cake tin on this. So if you wanna test your cake, just put a toothpick or a fork in the middle of your cake and pull it out. See, it should be coming out very clear, and it should, and do not demold it right away. You should not take out your cake out of your pan when it is too hot. You have to bring it to your room temperature and then demold it from your cake tin. Cool down and then I'm demolding it. Yeah. So yeah. This is how the cake looks like.
Wow.